the British Prime Minister, you know, Boris Johnson, they pulled a sneaky one on him. They pulled a sort of a slick move, right? So what happened is he resigned as Prime Minister, and he did that precisely not because of all the scandals that came before, but because his cabinet, you know, you had several key ministers, the health minister, the head of the treasury, you know, they resigned. And that's embarrassing. You know, when you have that happen to you, you have to resign as prime minister. You cannot stay on. So, you know, basically, this is what happened just a few weeks back. You know, Prime Minister Boris Johnson, he quit after more than 50 members of parliament resigned from his government within 48 hours. I mean, this, you look at that and you can't help but think that this was planned, right? They planned this stuff. That's why I say they pulled a sneaky on him. So he resigned. That's how it goes. He knows politics. You know, he knows how it is. He's a big boy, as they say. And now the question is, who's going to replace him, right? I don't even know if it's worth asking this question, if we should even bother, because it's going to be the same old, isn't it? It's going to be the same old. It's certainly going to be someone from the Conservative Party. It's either going to be Rishi Sunak or Liz Truss. So Liz Truss, she is currently the foreign minister, right? Or the foreign secretary, as we say, but just to simplify. And Sunak, he's the head of the treasury, right? And let me just show you very briefly how this goes, because there are not going to be any elections in the UK. And I know this sounds very weird to people in the US, because, you know, you're thinking if the president quits, well, you just have somebody else, take over. How does that work? Where are the elections? What's going on? You know, this is how it goes. Basically, they're sending ballot papers, okay, for people to vote on, to like 160,000 people. And these are all Conservative Party members, right? Before that, however, there's some sort of like secret process where they eliminate the candidates. So you'll have 10 people saying, I want to be the prime minister. Please let me go. They go through them until there's just two left. And these are the two left. This is what we have. Like I told you, we have Liz Truss and Rishi Sunak. So either one of these people is going to be the next British prime minister. But of course, no one in Britain is actually picking them, right? That's the funny part. And you had many prime ministers like that. Right? Was Theresa May voted in? I don't remember that. you have people within the party choosing the next prime minister. 160,000 people choosing that for, you know, millions of others. It's very funny, right? Real democracy, as you can tell. A real democracy. It's just so good. And the next elections are in 2024, in 2 years. The next general elections, of course. They're basically doing a profile on these people. They're saying that, oh, well, this guy, you know, he's Asian background. His parents emigrated from India to the UK. And, you know, he's one of the people who helped oust Johnson because he resigned from his cabinet, right? So he basically ushered on this whole process. And the issue with him is that he's a rich kid, right? So they say here, born a rich kid out, who's completely out of touch. That's the point. They say that he's born to Indian parents who moved to the UK from East Africa. Sunak was the head boy at the exclusive Winchester College private school and later studied at Oxford. And they say his elite education and work in investment banking could make him seem out of touch with ordinary voters. And so basically what's happened is you have this like little clip that's come out where he's saying that he has no working class friends. I'm just going to play it to you. It speaks for itself, really.
I have friends who are aristocrats. I have friends who are upper class. I have friends who are, you know, working class. But I'm not working class. But I mix and match. And then I go to see kids from an inner city state school and tell them, you know, to apply to Oxford and talk to them about people like me. And then I shock them at the end of chatting to them for half an hour and tell them I was at Winchester. And, you know, one of my best friends is from Eton or whatever, you know. And then they're like, oh, okay.
Yes, old boy. Yes, I went to Winchester. Yes, and then and Eton and Oxford. Yes, and all my friends come from there as well. Yes, it's a jolly good show, old boy. Yes, I have working class. Actually, no, I don't have any working class friends. To hell with those bloody peasants. Wow. Wow. I don't know how old this clip is, because you have people saying, well, he was like 20 when he said that. That's like 20 years ago. Come on, can you really hold him against him? I don't know. But this is what people are talking about. So I'm showing it to you because it's relevant. And basically, you know, people are saying that he's out of touch and he looks down on working class people. And yeah, they're trying to like, you know, screw his bid with that. That's what's going on. And then we have with Liz Truss, who thinks she's Margaret Thatcher, right? So that's basically everything I can tell you about her. She, you know, she's the foreign minister. I was actually shocked when they made her the foreign minister because I never heard of her. Never heard of her. And she's suddenly the foreign minister. So she's a top diplomat. And you saw her like last month. She was sitting with the foreign minister of India and, you know, chatting to all these people. It's just weird. But, you know, that's what I love about the UK. It's really like, we say, oh, we're a democracy. But you see these people in power just basically swapping positions around. You'll have somebody who's like the foreign minister who then out of nowhere, they're suddenly the health minister. Apparently they know things about health. And then, you know, they'll go and jump and become the mayor of London and they go back to minister. Or no, usually you go up, so you go from mayor to that. But, you know, they'll go from one ministerial job to the next and then suddenly they're in a bid to become prime minister. And no one's ever heard of these people. Who the hell are these people? I really want to know who the hell are these people that are running the country? Did anyone vote for them? No one has ever heard of these people. No one votes for them. And then suddenly in the fucking government in number 10 or in Whitehall or wherever, you know, it's unbelievable. So this is what's going on. This is what we have, you know, just like the most boring two people on the planet running to become prime minister. Who the hell cares, man? You know, it's the same crap. So again, you know, they're saying that it's either going to be her or it's going to be Sunak on the right becoming prime minister. And if you go down here and you look at the profile they've done and they say like, oh, she's like Thatcher. They actually mean that. Look at this. This is so cringy. It's so, so cringy. Oh, my God. They say that as a 7-year-old in 1983, Liz Truss, who was the daughter of left-wing activists, played the role of Margaret Thatcher in her school's mock elections, yet she couldn't gain a single vote. What is that supposed to mean? Are we supposed to like her more? Oh God, this photo, it's really something, man. It's believed she has been carefully cultivating her leadership credentials ever since. I still don't know what that means. That's just like... that's so vague. They say she campaigned for the UK to remain in the EU, but then she became a champion of Brexit. Yeah, well, it's not like she really had a choice, because if you're the bloody foreign minister and, you know, this country wants to make a trade deal with you and you agree as a government, you have to go sign it whether you like it or not. Shall we make a comparison with Thatcher, with Liz Truss? Let's put them together. Oh, God. Oh, God, this is so horrible. This is so cringe. I regret... Oh, God. I hate it. I hate it so bad. What the fuck is this monstrosity? Oh, my God. She's even dressing like her. It's unbelievable. I thought they were joking. No. She actually means it. Wow. What are we doing? What is this country doing? Have you people gone nuts? Oh, my God. Maybe Patel would be a better choice. Like, I can't believe I'm saying that. They're all so horrible. They are all so horrible, and they're all cut from the same cloth, right? Whether you like it or not, at the end of this election, where, you know, most of the country doesn't get to participate, it's going to be conservative, right? It's just this picture is so cringe. I don't even know what to say. I'm actually shocked that Priti Patel isn't in there. That's the only surprise to me. Priti Patel, she's really smart, isn't she? She's really, I should say cunning. I think cunning is the right word. I hope she doesn't take away my citizenship. That's a very nervous laugh. But seriously, like she's the Home Secretary, and you know, just given all the things that she's doing, you know that she's going to end up in a bid to become Prime Minister, right? I just feel like she's eyeing that role, and she's been eyeing that role for quite some time. Maybe she thought that she should stay on as home as the because just let me be very clear. You know, while Sunak resigned, for example, she didn't. So that already tells you a lot that she didn't resign, and I guess she just wants to stay on as Home Secretary. Right, she's been doing a lot of damage as Home Secretary. I've told you this so many times, and I'll keep saying it. I'm kind of just shocked at the amount of bills, the horrific, you know, authoritarian bills that she has put forward. For example, the Overseas Operations Bill, where they're basically saying that, you know, British troops who've committed war crimes, if it's older than 5 years, they just get immunity from prosecution for that. And then they had the Spy Cops Bill, where basically they're giving any undercover agent in the UK remember, I'm saying any, so that means even outside the police. There's a list of agencies that we went through. They're just ridiculous, right? And they're giving these people with undercover identities legal power to kill, to rape, to torture. Like, they have blanket immunity from all crimes. It's insane. It's nuts. Like, you read this and you're like, what? This is not a bill. This is a plot for like some kind of thriller. And then, of course, they have the recent nationality and borders bill, where they're saying that, you know, she meaning Priti Patel, she can take away anybody's citizenship, and she doesn't even have to tell them if it's too hard to reach them, whatever that means, right? What does that mean? They gave you one missed call. They don't know your number. You're on the moon. Like, this is so abstract. And of course, it basically tries to discourage, you know, migrants, refugees, trying to hurt them really bad. You know, if they're going to criminalize that, make them feel like there's, you know, like they're doing something wrong. And that's very bad, because it goes against the Refugee Convention, which the UK helped to not only sign but helped to author. So this is very wrong, also on an international level, because it's violating an international agreement. So lots of wrong things that she's done. Many, many bills that we've covered here on the channel, and I'm just shocked. That's her. That's Priti Patel. That's our Home Secretary, as you can see, right? Very, very, very charming lady. She does have an air about her, I will say. I'm saying all these nice things to, like, to save myself. That's her, Priti Patel. In any case, I expect to see her, you know, make a bid for the premiership at some time. But Boris Johnson is gone. You know, he's out. But he'll still be the prime minister until the next one is chosen. The scandals that they're pinning this on, they said things like COVID, for example. They say things like he didn't handle COVID well. There was a scandal about the lockdowns. You know, basically while they were telling people you're not allowed to bury your deceased mother or whatever, you know, like, God forbid, you're not allowed to bury your family, you're not allowed to visit your sick family. While they were enforcing that, he was having drinks. They were all having drinks in number 10, right? So basically, like, one set of rules for you, the public, and one set of rules for us. Like, we can violate our own lockdown rules. Very, very nice, right? Very fancy. The arrogance is really something. And then they point out to a bunch of, you know, this article on BBC, they basically said five things that led to the PM's downfall, and they go through them. And Partygate, this is exactly what I just described to you. They called it Partygate. You know, I really think it wasn't really just that, because if it were, he would have already resigned. I think it was more of them pulling a sneaky on him. You know, you had this was orchestrated. When you have 50 people resigning at once in 48 hours, and two of your cabinet members resigning, that's planned. They're sticking a knife in him. I'm not defending him in any way at all. I just told you a lot of things quite to the contrary about his government, right? Because Patel is part of that. But yeah, that looked a bit orchestrated to me. I could be wrong, but you know, that's what it looks like to me.